ladies and gentlemen, it's a big pleasure to come back here to play in Istanbul. Just to say a little bit, the first piece I played, probably as you know, that the usual Bach repertoire on guitar are the lute suites Bach wrote for the lute, and we usually play on the guitar. But recently, I've been working on the six sonatas and partitas Bach wrote for the violin, because they are considered as masterpieces. And even now, they still give troubles to the modern violinists. And so I've chosen the first sonata to play tonight, and the second fugue Bach transcribed to lute himself too. And now we move to Spain. I'm going to play two well-known pieces by Spanish composer Isaac Albéniz. Actually, he was a virtuosic pianist and a composer, but because the sound of the guitar very often appeared in his piano compositions, so when his piano works transcribe back to the guitar, they sound more authentic. So I'm playing two pieces from Suite Española, number 47. Advertised concert time is correct. Well, the concert title is From Bach to Brazil, because I've been long admired Brazilian music, and there are lots of guitarists in Brazil that play the Brazilian style. And I'm going to play the Brazilian hero composer, Carlos Antonio Jobim, who is a great admirer of Bach's music. And I'm choosing three pieces by him. The first one, Magidia, and the second one, Luisa. They're both love songs. And I've heard from a Brazilian musician who said the Luisa is probably the most tender song from Brazil. And then the last one, Felicidade, it means happiness in Portuguese. And it's used in the movie Black Orfeo. And the movie made this piece very popular. Chopin is my favorite composer. Unfortunately, he's never written a single piece by guitar, although it is said that he loved the guitar. And I played the piano for a few years as well, so I've long admired his music, and I've accepted the challenge to have transcribed two popular valses by him onto the guitar. So the first one is a slow one I played on the piano, and the second one, Grand Brilliant Valse, is a very difficult one even on the piano. So I hope Chopin would like my guitar version in heaven.
Thank you.
I'm going to play a Chinese piece. It's called Butterfly Lovers, and it's probably the most famous piece in China. And it was based on a 2,000 years old tragedy love story. And the story is very similar to the Western love story, Romeo and Juliet. But the difference is at the end, after the couple died, they transformed to a pair of butterflies and forever together. So in 1960s, there were two composition students in China. They used the local opera material to have written a violin concerto, which lasted 25 minutes, and it immediately became very popular in China. So I've transcribed the first movement of the concerto. So at the beginning, you would hear a pair of butterflies flies in from distance, and then the music describes how the young couple met and how they fell in love. And in the end of the first movement, the music describes they parted very reluctantly.
Thank you.
back to Spain. As you know, that the famous Spanish composer Joaquin Rodrigo, who wrote the most famous guitar concerto, Aranjuez, which I've just recorded. And this concerto was dedicated to a Spanish guitarist called Regino Sanz de la Maza. And actually, de la Maza helped Rodrigo to write this piece because Rodrigo couldn't play the guitar. So now I'm going to play three pieces written by Sanz de la Maza. And these three pieces are all in the flamenco style form. The first two are very old Spanish songs. And the last one, Zapateado, is a dance on the hill.
Thank you.
For me, the Invocation and Dance by Rodrigo is his best solo work. And also it means something quite special for me, because when I gave my first concert in Madrid, Rodrigo attended my concert, and I played this piece in my concert, and we shook hands during the intermission. So since then, I grew an affinity to his music, and I've just recorded this piece also alongside with his concerto. And this piece was dedicated to his great friend and mentor, Manuel de Falla. In fact, in this piece, he used a few quotes from Falla's music. So in the beginning, it's like a ghost started to pray in front of Falla's grave, and later on the ghost became dancing. And Rodrigo wrote this piece during a period when he was very depressed, so it's a quite dark and impressed, intense piece. Since this piece was dedicated to Manuel de Falla, so I'm going to play two dances from de Falla's ballet, Three-Cornered Hat, and I'm going to play these pieces continuously.
Thank you.
clap now?
Thank you.
Kishkular. Thank you. Thank you very much. It's a very difficult one. I'm going to play for first time in Paraguay very soon. And maybe there's some guitarists here, as you know, Barrios, famous composers from there. And I'm going to play a Paraguay dance, number one. I just learned it a few days ago, so hopefully it will go well. One of my favorite pieces.